I wonder why. Richard Dujian is an architect. He calls himself Archimaniac. Is that pronounced correctly?
Yes, it is.
Okay, he's an Archimaniac architect. He's got this thing about coffins and ghosts. And Richard is from the Lebanon. Has everyone been to the Lebanon? One person, there you go. So, I wonder what Richard's going to talk about. I'll leave it up to you. Are you plugged in there? Richard, please. Thank you very much. Please give him a warm hand.
So, tonight, I'm going to talk to you about ghosts. If you believe in ghosts, please raise your hand. Wow, so many people. I'm shocked and surprised. Thank you. But unfortunately, I'm not talking about these kind of ghosts tonight. Sorry, you're going to be disappointed. I'm going to talk about ghosts very specific to Kyoto. And they can be found, as far as I know, only in Kyoto. And moreover, you can see them more clearly during the day than during the night. So the ghosts I'm going to talk to you about are ghosts that exist in urban contexts, such as this. I don't know if you can notice, inside the circle, there is a ghost. Can you see it? No? Well, how about now? Can you see the ghost? It's right in the middle of the circle. Please remember that we're not talking about anthropomorphic ghosts. We're talking more about urban ghosts. So, in case you haven't guessed yet, I'm talking about not this guy, I'm talking about this ghost here, which is the remnant of Kyoto Machiya. When they get destroyed, Kyoto Machiya, and depending on their closeness to the building to be constructed, they leave traces on it. So there are specific haunted sites in Kyoto, such as open-air car parks. As you can see here, they try to erase it, but unfortunately the ghost is more powerful than the people, and it tries to survive and appear more. So, a second haunted space are access spaces to house, to private houses and buildings. When they destroy Machiya, and the new house built is further away from the street, the trace of the Machiya is left, as you can see here. So this is also a haunted site. Another haunted site is passageway. They destroy the house to build a passageway, either pedestrian or vehicular. And here's the ghost. As you can see, there are different types of ghosts. I'm going to talk about it later. This is a more difficult type to find because it's an in-between spaces of buildings. When two buildings are built instead of a Machiya, as you can see here, you can very difficultly find the Machiya, the ghost, sorry. The Machiya is dead, the ghost is living. So therefore you have to look very carefully in Kyoto to find these ghosts. Other types are more easier to find when they are set in urban voids. As you can see here, it's a gigantic one. If you have a faint heart, don't look at it. You might be very scared and die. So here, as you can see, there's a potential building that's going to be built. Construction sites are also very fertile haunting sites. As the house is destroyed, the building is being built, and yet, if you go quickly to that site, you can still see it and enjoy it, if you're not scared. I have collected more than 80 cases for now, and divided and categorized them in 6 different sites. Until now, so it's, these are the 80 cases, but there are still cases popping up, and I'm categorizing them. So the type 1 are the easiest to see and to find, because as you see, like here, the ghost is covered up with one material or another. It depends on the cost the people are ready to spend. So either tin or wood. The taktu is sort of like a just a shadow, really an illusion of what used to exist there. So maybe this case is the true ghost between all the cases that I'm going to talk to you about. And depending on the lighting, you can see it easier or more difficult. Type 3 is a type of ghost that is carved in the building. You can see it, sort of a bas-relief carved in the wall of the building that was built. Type 4 is the case where the material of the ghost on the building is completely different from that of the existing building. As you see here, not very clearly because of some problems. The type 5 is here, also not easy to see because it's just a piece of the old Machiya stuck to the built building. So in this case, this building, when it was being built, it was really sticking to the Machiya. Therefore, a piece of it stayed on it. The type 6 is a combination of all of the above cases. Like here we have a difference of material and color and even the piece of the roof, which is stuck to the wall. This is in Gion Shijo, by the way, Kawabata-dori. Here we have some sort of threat to ghosts. The threat to Machiya already exists. They are destroyed, but there are threats to ghosts. As you can see here, it's a very nice, very beautiful, clear one. They built a new house, and they just painted over it. I'm not talking about this work. This is a potential ghost. You see this teeny tiny dwarf Machiya sitting between these two large, scary towers. In a few months, in a few days maybe, in a few years, nobody knows. This will disappear. It will leave a ghost behind, and maybe something new will come up. And if you are lucky, we might see the ghost, but it might just disappear. So this was only a small introduction to the ghost of Kyoto. It's a sort of an awareness project that I'm working on. And from here on, I will continue in different ways to explore better the haunted sites and the different sites. Thank you very much.